welcome to I'm Woke. I'm your host, Emelina. Today, I'm going to be taking you through the Ascension Energy Updates for April. If you're new to my channel, my name is Emmy or Emelina. I channel Akashic Records energy updates every month. I'm a high performance spiritual coach. I do life and business coaching. Tap that subscribe button and tap the bell for notifications so you don't miss any energy updates. Without further ado, let's jump right in. The first theme is that right now this probably feels like a really, really big transition for you. I've been noticing a lot there's two versions of yourselves here. There is the version that you've been in the past, and there is this totally new version of yourself. And what's happening right now at this time is we're kind of standing right in between the two versions, going, wait, something doesn't feel the same. Like, I know who I've been, and I feel really uncomfortable. You might be feeling just uncomfortable and uncertain in this in-between transition space while you are becoming the new version of yourself. Many of us are in such a great time of transition right now that it just feels uncomfortable. You might just like feel a little crunchy about this process. It'll feel really uncertain because you're just not quite sure how you do things yet. But you can tell that you're changed. You can tell that you're changing. You can tell that there's new things coming for you, new thoughts, new beliefs, new experiences, that you are about to experience a very different aspect of your life. And you can choose right now that that difference is something really exciting, that it's your absolute best, because there's nothing more true than that. That's what we're stepping into. There's a really big space right now of all of us stepping into our higher aspects as humans, of us stepping into our highest potential, into our greatness. And it just feels really different right now. And in the process, you're gonna begin to surrender into, I'm not sure how this version of myself acts or thinks or behaves yet, but I'm gonna surrender that I'm gonna know in the moment how to decide how to move forward, how to decide what it is that I'm choosing, and to decide what to create on the day-by-day basis. And it will feel very much like a moment-to-moment, day-by-day situation, because we don't all know quite who we are yet in this new phase, this new chapter of our lives. The second big theme of this time right now is that this might feel messy. This is going to feel messy. Being human is a very messy process. You might be releasing big emotions. You might be exhausted. You might be tired. You might be getting sick. You might be thinking that your entire life is falling apart. This is a very natural part of the process. The process is meant to be messy. In the divine, in our potential realities, when we're reading our different potential that we have available, it feels more clean, because when you're thinking about your potential, when you're fantasizing, what you're really doing is exercising your mental belief and moving through patterns and processes and what do I want in my life? Who do I want to become? And that feels easier than it does to actually be human, to drop in and to start to activate what that's going to mean for you. What that activation is messy. It feels emotional. It can feel dramatic. You could be going on a complete emotional roller coaster. Many of you probably are. You can let me know in the comments. You might just feel down for the day and not know why. And a lot of this is that all of you are processing so much energy. There is so much momentum at this time that we're processing a lot of things like a quantum computer almost, processing all of these different ascension upgrades as if we're being given big software upgrades, as if the human body is a computer, because it kind of is. And in the process of upgrading and becoming something new, we can get tired because the body has to adjust to the actual spiritual energetic alignment. And the body takes an extra minute, and the body has emotions. And you might be very, very messy in this process, and you might be upset, and you might be like quick to snap at things and just not know why, or quick to be sad, or just like allow it. You might just be very tired, and that's okay. Allow it. It'll move through. It's temporary, it's impermanent, and it will make the way for you to feel better later, whether it's in an hour, whether it's tomorrow, whether it's next week. Know that this is normal. There are a lot of ascension symptoms at this time. I'm just hearing left and right, people are really tired. Just allow that to be okay as you're stepping into this new process, as you're integrating these new energies that are coming both from the planetary alignment commitments and other people and everything else. The next big theme I have for you guys is to surrender. So in the process of you knowing that there's a past version of yourself and there's this current version and you're in the transition, you want to surrender. Every morning when you wake up, literally just be like, I surrender. I surrender to my higher self. I surrender to spirit. I surrender to my new self. I surrender to this being easy. I surrender. Go with the flow. You will be inspired in many different ways than you have in the past to act differently, to perceive differently. You'll have different thoughts and emotions than you traditionally do. Allow it. Take the hunches. Like if you're in a position where you're like, you know, normally I would go to this coffee shop or I would go to see this friend, but I don't know that I'm feeling it. This other opportunity has presented itself to me. I'm just getting a hunch that I should go to this different restaurant or this different event or hang out with this different person, and it's going to feel different, and that's okay. Surrender. There is so much lining up. There is so much synchronicity. The amount of relationships, people, financial stability, events that will be coming your way to support you is tremendous. But in order to activate it and receive it, you have to surrender into allowing yourself to be different, allowing yourself to steer yourself in a different direction that might feel unnatural because you haven't done it before, but it'll feel natural because you'll just feel this impulse within yourself to lead yourself forward in that direction. Trust it, run with it, sprint with it. The synchronicities are gonna line up like crazy. They certainly have been for me and the people I've been encountering. So continue to surrender to the process. You might not know what this is gonna look like for you, and that's okay. It's almost like you know that you have to change. You know that you have different priorities moving forward, and it's so different than how you've done things in the past that can just create a lot of uncertainty. So to combat, to move forward through the uncertainty, surrender. Moment to moment basis, I surrender. When you start to feel overwhelmed, and that is something that's coming forward a lot, surrender, I surrender. I feel overwhelmed, I surrender. I'm gonna choose the right direction, the right next step, even if I don't know exactly what it is yet, but I surrender to that. Show me what that is, spirit. Show me what that is, higher self. Show me what that is, self. What does my new self do? How does she or he act? How do they perceive? And I'm just going to trust that I'm gonna take the next step, even if it feels very different than anything I've ever done in the past. The next big theme is to monitor your thoughts and feelings. You are attracting absolutely everything that you are encountering, and you're attracting everything that you're running into, that you're experiencing, based on your own inherent beliefs and your expectations of your reality. Now, you can track your beliefs and your expectations based on your active thoughts that you have and based on how you feel. You'll know what you're thinking based on how you're feeling. So if you're feeling down or upset, that's a good time to start journaling or to sit down for a brief meditation, even for 2 minutes, and say, what have I been thinking? And then track through the thoughts, observe the thoughts. What am I thinking? Are those thoughts in alignment with something that I want, that I would actually choose as an experience? Or am I choosing insecurities? Am I choosing things that aren't beneficial for me? And just in the process of monitoring your own thoughts, you can re-choose. Instead of assuming a negative result for an event or a relationship or something you're encountering, you can choose in the moment, you know, this might be a little different, but why don't I assume the best? I'm gonna assume the best right now and then choose different thoughts. I'm gonna assume the best right now and then choose the momentum of the different feelings, which can be joy. You can choose joy, you can choose bliss, you can choose excitement over overwhelm. You're attracting all of your experiences, and all the things that you are experiencing are unfolding to match the expectations that you believe that you can have, what you feel like you're worthy of. So in any now moment, bring your attention back to your thoughts and re-choose. Choose something that feels better. What feels good right now? What do I prefer right now? And choose the preference, choose the positive expectation, choose the belief. Things get to work out for you moving forward. This is gonna be a new mantra that you guys are gonna see just across the board where you're being presented with, that you're gonna wanna speak to yourself. I choose the better reality. I choose what I want. I choose to experience the absolute best. I choose the good feeling thoughts. I choose the good feeling feelings, and I allow everything else to be let go. And the last theme I have for you, you probably are feeling like you have changed. And if you haven't felt it, know that it's coming. You have fundamentally, inherently changed. Who you are is different now. And you're in the process of feeling that in-between moment of what was and what is now, and who it is that you are now. You're awakening to your greatness. You are in your absolute best self. And the new version of yourself, the new phase of who it is that you are, is now here. You can't do things the way you've done things in the past. And that might feel uncomfortable, but you know what's gonna feel more comfortable? Is you realizing that you have just stepped into your greatness. That it's not a question of whether or not you are in your greatness. At this point, you are. There are so many themes right now around supporting. You are in your power. You are in your awakening. You are in your empowerment, your greatness, everything that it is that you want to create in this world has become. It is part of who you are right now. This is a big step in the ascension energies that have presented themselves for April. So you have to know that you have already changed. There is nothing to do to get there, to change yourself now. Now it's about settling into the fact that you are different. You feel different even to yourself. You're perceiving yourself differently. And then just exploring, taking the time every day to explore, who am I now? What choices feel better to me now? What emotions feel better? What thoughts feel better? And just riding the wave of it, just trying it, just exploring this new version of yourself as if you were to get a new wardrobe and explore trying on different clothes. Explore expressing yourself in different ways. Explore speaking your truth and see how you respond to yourself, how others respond to you, and then how you perceive that response and what you do about it. Like, you are trying on different clothes now. You are trying on this new aspect of yourself and how it is that you think, you believe, you expect, you create, how you move and act in this world, and what choices you make along the way. I hope this is really helpful for you guys. April is a really, really, really powerful month, especially moving into the next few months. There are big identity shifts that we've all made, and we're going to be learning who it is that we are in the process. And instead of that being overwhelming or uncomfortable, we can choose that can be really exciting. That it's exciting to get a whole new wardrobe of clothes and try them on. That it's exciting to try different experiences. That it's exciting to express yourself in many different ways and just see what happens. That it's exciting to give up control. That it's exciting to choose new and see what happens from your new choices. That you can just try on different aspects of yourself. You can be creative, you can pick up new hobbies, you can explore maybe new career opportunities or see what it would be like to try on in your mind if you were to change jobs. Or there's so much change happening right now and there's just so much exploration behind it. So give yourself that permission to explore. I hope this video is super helpful for you guys. I have so much love for each and every one of you. And as always, if you like this video, please remember to go tap the like button below. It helps YouTube promote the content and we need that. Leave a comment. I'd love to hear what you guys are experiencing through these ascension updates through April. Remember to subscribe, tap that bell for notifications. And as always, I'm also going to leave some links in the description below on the multitude of ways that you can work with me, whether it is jumping onto the wait list for my Akashic Records immersion program that's going to be coming up shortly. I have a big radical authenticity program about claiming your power that I'm in development with now that I'm going to be launching shortly as well. You can find a link in the description below to jump on the wait list. And of course, I work with people one-on-one who are looking to create a really active transformation over the next 6 to 12 months as a spiritual high performance coach alongside coaching in the Akashic Records and your higher self. You can find all of the information in the description below. Until next time, guys, have a wonderful month and I will see you all soon.